You could have the best single turbo in the world and it still doesn't compare to compounds.
The reason for this is because with turbochargers, you have two turbos working in sequence, a small one and a large one. This turbo takes in air and compresses it. Then it turbocharges the second turbo, which then takes that compressed air already and compresses it further and then turbocharges the engine. These two turbos aren't just adding air onto each other. They're actually multiplying the amount of air that's going into the engine. Two turbos will give you about 4 times as much air as a stock turbo alone. Compressing that much more air into the cylinder of the engine does a lot of good things for the truck. Better fuel mileage, significantly lowers EGTs, improves performance and horsepower, and even your torque. If you think about your RPM band, with a single turbo, it can only cover so much of the RPM band. If it's a small turbo, it's going to cover the low end and cut out mid or a little bit before mid-range. If it's a medium-sized turbo, it'll cover the mid-range, but your spool-up and your upper range will be weak. If it's a big turbo, it'll cover the upper range, but your spool-up is going to be really, really slow. With compounds, it covers almost all the RPM band and gives you air from the beginning with a small turbo all the way through mid-range to the top end, and you never run out of air. This is why a single turbo can never outperform a compound setup.